So Discovery Wrestling is coming in October. Tell us a little bit how Discovery came to be.
Well, Discovery is the brainchild of myself and a good friend of mine, Alex Fowlis. This time last year, we were both going through a pretty hard time personally. You know, he just lost his dad. I had stuff going on. And actually, we used to just go out and grab a cup of tea. You know, we used to go out, grab a cup of tea, grab a bit of lunch, and we would just chat and catch up, make sure we're both okay and everyone's fine. And then we just started, obviously, as you do, as both wrestling fans, you start talking ideas, and you think, oh, God, wouldn't it be cool if this, or wouldn't it be cool if that happened, or you know, if something was done this way, or something was done that way. And before we knew it, we'd come up with this new concept of ours for Discovery Wrestling. And, yeah, here we are, not far away now from the first Discovery show.
So it's like, for other people, for wrestling fans, it's like, let's have a bar. Let's make a bar. It's like, it's for wrestling fans, it's, let's make a wrestling promotion.
Well, yeah, absolutely. I mean, because we're all in this business of wrestling because we enjoy it. We, you know, we're fans in the first place. That's how you get into it, and that's how you get a taste for it. And we're now, you know, we sit down and we go, you know, even not just from a kind of fans' point of view, wouldn't it be cool if so-and-so faced so-and-so, or wouldn't it be cool if this type of match happened, but from kind of a business aspect and a business standpoint as well, is wouldn't it be cool if things worked like this, or if things worked like that, and just trying to do something slightly differently without trying to impose your own ways on someone else and someone else that's already kind of been established, is to kind of go, right, okay, let's try it this way, let's try and do it something just slightly differently and see how it works. It could blow up in our faces, you know, we could get to October and it could fall apart. It will not fall apart. It'll be amazing, it'll be incredible, it'll be one of the best shows this year. But it's just, we wanted to try doing something differently for ourselves.
And so why Edinburgh? Why was Edinburgh going to be your debut?
Well, if you look at wrestling across Scotland at the moment, there's so many promotions across Scotland at the moment, and there's a handful of them that are doing incredibly well in their areas, in their towns, in their cities. Obviously, wrestlers in Aberdeen, fantastic, massive shows. SW and Dundee, again, the likes of Hell for Lycra, their big shows in the Bonner Hall are doing phenomenally well. Across in Glasgow, you've got ICW, you've got SWA, you've got PBW doing their way, you've got BCW doing their way, and then you look at Edinburgh and you've got, obviously got ICW do their over-18s on the Sundays, but nobody really hits the kind of family-friendly thing in a big way in Edinburgh, in a city the size of Edinburgh. So we thought, well, if we can go and put on an incredible show, really well produced with fantastic talent, it's something that perhaps could be become a home for us in Edinburgh and do something in a big way. It's a huge city. And if you get your venue, your standard venue, then we can make something of it and make something really special for wrestling fans as well.
So you're also a professional wrestler. Mm. So have you found it easier or harder, being that you've started as a professional wrestler and got into promoting, or do you find it has hindered you in any way?
Well, I'm not sure. I mean, I think, you know, being given the chance by the SW to wrestle and seeing, you know, everything kind of behind the scenes and seeing how everything is done in their way and then meeting everybody and just, you know, from speaking to people, I think that's kind of helped in a way, because you speak to people from all over and you speak to people who from different backgrounds, and they all share experiences of this and this and this, and I think that's potentially helped as well, because I wouldn't have got that otherwise if I'd just gone in without having the background of being in different locker rooms, you know, not just SW but all over Scotland or in Europe or wherever I've been. You know, you get the different experiences, and I wouldn't have had those experiences if I wasn't a professional wrestler, if I wasn't a wrestler and being asked to perform in these places. I would never have had seen, experienced all the different places and how different people do different things.
Yeah, and it also would have helped how to put together your show as well. So on to October, you've got probably the most stacked debut show that I've ever possibly seen, with guys like Chris Sabin and Crime Time. So tell us a little bit about your debut show.
Well, we knew we had to make it big to start off with. We needed, you know, because as we mentioned, there's so many promotions across Scotland, so many promotions doing similar things, using similar guys. So we thought, in order to kind of stand out, especially from our first show, we'll have to do something big. It has to be massive, you know. So that's why we look at talents and go, okay, well, Chris Sabin, you know, we've been speaking to Chris Sabin and he was available, so let's get Chris Sabin, because he's a guy, he was, like, not so long ago, the TNA heavyweight champion. He's an 8-time X Division champion. and he kind of embodies what I want from a kind of a specialist division that I'm trying to create. It's kind of been given the nickname the Y division because, you know, people kind of compare it to the X division and the style of what we're looking at. But Chris Sabin was perfect for that. Crime Time just came about because, unfortunately, we had originally booked Al Snow. Just in my head, I always seen Al Snow going up against Grado. I thought it would be a lot of fun, you know, get a lot of attention. But after we booked Al Snow, a couple of months later, TNA announced they were going to do a pay-per-view the night after our show in Japan. And Al Snow is an agent and a producer with TNA. So we got in touch with him and just said, hey Al, how does this affect you? And he came back after speaking in his office a couple of weeks later and said, well, I'm needed for Japan, I'm really sorry. And we can't get upset, we can't get angry about that, because at the end of the day, that's where he makes his full-time living from. So we needed replacements, and we were in touch with Crime Time's agent, who'd kind of come up with a number of other stars. And we just thought, you know what, Crime Time would be a lot of good fun to come over. They've never done the UK independently before. JTG obviously is very recent to WWE's past and has a bit of a following for picking up his phone on that day when everyone got released. So I think it'll be a lot of fun with those two guys. Someone else we've got coming across is Mike Mondo. People may not know the name first off. If you think Mikey in the Spirit Squad, and he was in the Spirit Squad for a number of years, and actually, do you know what? Like the gimmick, people look back and they go, oh yeah, they were male cheerleaders, they were just a joke, they were just a gimmick. But Mike actually was on the road those entire years with WWE. Night after night, he was fighting Shawn Michaels, he was fighting Ric Flair, he was fighting Triple H. Here's a guy who's been in the ring with these guys, you know, every night of the week for live shows. And he's incredible talent. Ric Flair's put him over in a huge way in recent podcasts, saying that Mike Mondo is one of the best workers in the world. And most recently, he was in Ring of Honor and made a huge impact there. So now we're fortunate that we've got him coming to Scotland. And again, another kind of independent first for us, the fact that he's coming over off the back of his run in Ring of Honor. And we're going to put him up against Joe Coffey, which the two styles will be an absolute beautiful match. It'll be incredible.
Speaking of Joe Coffey, you've also got some of the best in the UK as well coming, including Damien O'Connor and even Ian Ambrose and Damien Daniels. So what was it like getting all these UK talent? Did you just pick a group of names that you wanted to contact and get in touch with them? Or?
Well, yeah, I think one of the fortunate things about starting something brand new, we don't have a training school. We don't have people that we're bringing through and developing. Do you know, there are fantastic schools right across Scotland, and we're not going to add to that with another training school. But we are fortunate because we're not kind of bringing through our own guys. We can look across the UK and think, well, I'd like him and I like him and I like him, and almost cherry pick and go, I like his style, I think that would mix well with his style, and really kind of really choose. I mean, a lot of the people who are involved in the first show are people I've personally worked with in the past, and I know them well, and that's kind of formed the first show for me, because one, I know they're good people, and two, I know they're fantastic workers. So I know bringing this mix of people together, it'll be just make for a great atmosphere, and putting together matches which people haven't seen in the UK as well, like Rampage Brown versus Damien O'Connor. Rampage is considered by most people as the best worker in the UK right now. Damien O'Connor, everyone in Scotland knows just how fantastic he is. So that match is going to be unbelievable. Then you've got guys like Damien, who has been up at WrestleZone. We've seen him in SWE in the past as well. I've always had such huge admiration for him. So to get him down to Edinburgh and to get him in front of a crowd that perhaps haven't seen him before, haven't gone up to Aberdeen to see him before, I think it's going to be fantastic. Like the same with Ian Ambrose. Ian Ambrose is just on fire right now. Everything he does turns to gold, whether it be his in-ring performances or his promos online. So again, putting him in front of a new crowd as well, I think there's so much potential and there's so much excitement surrounding it for me, because I know how good this can be, and I just hope come October that everyone else kind of shares what it is that I can see.
One final question: if anyone's not sure about attending Discovery Wrestling, what would you say to them? What makes it different?
It's different because you're going to see matches you've never seen anywhere else before. You're going to see opponents who've never faced each other before in any other promotion. You're going to see big name talent coming over from America who have never done the independent scene in Scotland before as well. So that's going to be different. There's going to be massive production around the show as well. Obviously, I don't want to give anything away on that regards. But all I can say is that when people come along, they're going to get their value for money. They're going to come along, they're going to see a top show. They're going to see absolute fantastic talent, amazing matches, and just have an all-round great day.
Perfect. Thank you.